Hello dear Steamians, DTubers, members of Uptrend, and all beautiful and creative blockchain people. That's me again at CryptoSpine. This is my next cryptocurrency market overview. So let's start. Let's have a look at the prices of the major cryptocurrencies according to the beautiful site of CoinGecko. And we see that Bitcoin is trading at significantly higher levels that they used to be a few days ago. So Bitcoin is trading at the level of $7,783. So its price has increased by 3.9% for the last 24 hours. And to some extent, now we're a little bit in the green zone. The same holds for the trajectory of the rest of the major cryptocurrencies, actually of their prices, such as Ethereum, XRP, Bitcoin Cash, Litecoin, and etc. We see that most of the price charts are in the green zone. And to some extent, this is, in my view, something positive. But we need time to evaluate how sustainable this price rebound is, because if we get back to the price charts, we're still in these descending channels that I have been commenting on many times. That's why today I won't comment again on the price charts of Bitcoin and Ethereum and Steam and etc. I just want to mention some interesting news, but of course we will get back to the price charts early at the very beginning of next week. Usually on Mondays and on Tuesdays I analyze the price charts of the cryptocurrencies. So let's move to some interesting crypto related news. The first thing I want to mention today is that I read a very nice article on Cointelegraph about Cardano and its cryptocurrency ADA. So the title says that Cardano's payments payment gateway for merchant is now live. So if we switch to the site of Cardano, if we move actually to the Cardano Foundation site, this is the announcement that was published recently that ADA Pay solution by Cardano Foundation and Soti is now live. So it was also published or highlighted on Cointelegraph as well. So it is about ADA payment, and actually this solution allows merchants to accept payments in ADA with a near instant settlement into 35 fiat currencies directly into their bank accounts. You can now start accepting ADA for your business by joining SotiPay platform or KotiPay platform. For more details, please visit their site. So I even checked the video, and according to the information, to the official information, it is now quite easy for businesses to set up some kind of crypto to fiat gateway, and they can accept ADA, and it doesn't require some special skills actually to set up these channels. So to be honest, I'm very happy when I hear or read such kind of news, because definitely it will facilitate the mass adoption of the cryptocurrencies when it makes the process of being paid or paying in crypto much easier. So thank you very much. I hope that it will to some extent support at least the price of ADA. And if we check, the price of ADA is in the green zone as well. Of course, I don't think that it is because of the publishment of this news. It is the general, let's say, market trend or price rebound current, because such kind of news, they are priced in much more earlier, because it is not an overnight process to launch such kind of solution. It needs time. So traders, they're prepared for such kind of news in advance. So according to my personal experience, it is already priced in such kind of news. Of course, if it facilitates the mass adoption of ADA in the long run much more faster than it is at the moment, it may support the price much more stronger. Now let's move to some other interesting news. The next one I want to mention is relating to IOTA. And we know that IOTA is also one of the top 21 crypto according to CoinGecko. And we know that it's based not on blockchain technology, it's Tangle. And I just want to mention that they published yesterday, this nice article on Medium. This is their blog. The first step towards a unified identity protocol. So unified identity protocol. So they are going to launch on a digital identity on IOTA. Unified identity protocol is a digital identity implementation built on their technology Tango. And of course, in this article, they say that to some extent there are some kind of, let's say, features or implementations on currently supported by Google and Facebook. They provide an estimation of identity. The process can be inaccurate with insufficient depth to user profiles, and in some cases the information is altogether false. Also, in the current, let's say, business environment, in business customer relationships, identification is usually sold via time-consuming and costly know-your-customer process. Fast, cheap, and trustworthy identification remains an unresolved problem. And because doing business, for example, in the internet needs some kind of trust between the different parties participating in the process, they propose this digital, decentralized digital identity, and the concept is the following. The concepts of the decentralized identifiers and verifiable credentials enable online identification of someone or something in a verifiable and trusted manner. So I read this article, and to some extent I do like such kind of implementations, but I'm not pretty sure how the rest of the cryptocurrency users will react to such kind of implementations, because someone really value highly, let's say, anonymity, and they would like to be more like behind the stage, not that they some people will not be will not want to require a lot of information about themselves or about their businesses. And probably IOTA will still have to adjust a little bit this process or this product to the different needs of the cryptocurrency users. But definitely this is something interesting, and I do like such kind of implementations, because in a globalized world, we need some kind of identification universal that is applicable all over the world, or actually all over the internet. And I do like such kind of implementations, and definitely it is some kind of additional use case in the cryptocurrency world that will facilitate, let's say, the mass adoption of the cryptocurrencies, at least in my view. And the last thing I want to mention today is quite an interesting product, to be honest. So this is a product that was just announced on the site of Blockstream. So we know that Blockstream is quite an active player, let's say, in the ecosystem of Bitcoin, and also in the cryptocurrency world, and many prominent cryptocurrency developers, Cypherpunks, let's say, they are involved with Blockstream. So this is a metal capsule, and I was very curious what it is about. This is actually the pride of the Blockstream capsule. So this is actually the capsule, this is the box, and let's have a look at the description. The Blockstream capsule is the all new way to store your keys in the physical world, bringing together user friendliness, robust materials, and an unassuming shape for maximum portability and stash ability. So actually, simply unscrew the capsule lid, slide the titles in the correct order to record your seed phrase, and seal it again for secure storage. Need more detailed instructions? Check out the video. So if we click on this video, I just want to show you that you can store actually your seed phrase and all your passwords in this way. So these are let's say the letters, and you have this capsule, and you can write your what was the name of this seed phrase of your seed phrase, and keep it in the capsule. And actually this is a nice gadget, but I realized that I think it's a little bit overpriced. I think that I can ask someone to make such kind of gadgets for me for price cheaper than the one at the site, but I may be wrong. So my question to you, fellow Steamians and YouTubers and Uptrendians, what do you think about this kind of gadgets? Would you like to have one and to store your seed phrase and let's say even passwords in such kind of block stream metal capsule? That's it for today. Thank you for watching. I wish you a wonderful day and hope to see you in my next video. That was me at CryptoSpark.